air data computer failures, working with David Hopkins in his airplane, and he has one air data computer, and it has just failed. The obvious components that have failed are the airspeed, the altitude, and the vertical speed. David, do you notice anything else that's failed?
The autopilot's not holding altitude.
Okay, very good. So you're really only going to be able to maintain your pitch with pitch mode, correct?
Yeah, which is what I did for the moment, yeah.
Go ahead and climb us to 5,500. Looking down at your standby altimeter, we're at 3,900. And
right.
Let's go ahead and climb up to 5,500. We'll set that here. But you'll have to scan down below to your analog instruments in order to gain that information as to how close you're getting to your new altitude of 5,500. We'll take a look down at the analogs now.
Okay, Postgres 54, 53, 5,800, climbing 7,000.
And your scan will need to go quickly between the analog instruments below and the primary flight display above. Basically using your AHARs for all your attitude and heading reference information, and using your standby altitude and airspeed for all your vertical information. Go ahead and turn right to a heading of 070 as we've got a restricted area ahead.
Bay Area in the Sierra.
So you can still see we've got terrain information on display. We've still got all our topography information, but we have lost our ability to see other traffic. You can see down below traffic has failed.
5453 IDEM.
Now at this point, if we're in VFR conditions, we'd want to stay in VFR conditions. If we're in IMC conditions, we'd probably want to use the autopilot for what we can use it for.
Clear direct Modesto, SCAS 5453.
And what can we currently do to maintain our heading of 070 and our altitude for 5,500? What can we do with the autopilot right now?
We can put it on right now, and it'll capture heading mode and pitch mode, so we'll be able to control our climb via the pitch mode on the autopilot.
Okay, very good. Go ahead and demonstrate that. So we've got heading holding very nicely. All of the lateral modes will work properly, but our vertical navigation is all going to be using the pitch on the autopilot in order to maintain climbs, level, and descents. Now we're approaching 5,500, but we can only tell that by the standby analog altimeter. And now we'd want to reduce our nose attitude. You're not going to be able to hit the altitude button.
Just seeing whether it was or not. But.
Yep, good to test it, but there's nothing there. So if it can't see it, then it can't target it for a level off. All right, very good. There's 5,500. Now, if you look at your green flight path indicator, you can see it's just below the horizon there. So you need to keep that just on.
Yeah.
And so you'll find yourself constantly tweaking the pitch by a half degree here and there in order to compensate for updrafts, downdrafts, any airspeed changes, or any adjustments to the flap configuration.
Yeah,
flap configuration is probably one of the biggest things, as it causes a sudden pitch moment. Now, we wouldn't want to shoot an instrument approach with this kind of a failure. Some airplanes have a second sensor. We'd check the sensor and we'd look for that other air data computer. It's supposed to hop automatically to the other ADC, but we don't have a second air data computer on this airplane. In the case that we're in IMC, we would want to ask for vectors to VFR conditions, and we'd allow NorCal or Center to know how much fuel we have, and what the approximate range of the aircraft is. in order to get out of the weather and towards better conditions. At worst, you'd want to fly an approach with marginal VFR if you didn't have the fuel range to get you to solid VFR CAVU conditions. Today we're going to simulate that we don't have enough fuel in order to appropriately get to VFR conditions, and so we're going to ask for an approach. What kind of an approach would you want to ask for with an ADC failure, David?
Only an ILS.
Only an ILS because?
You have no altitude information, and therefore the GPS can't track altitude.
Very good.
And you certainly wouldn't want a VOR approach in those conditions.
Yeah, you want to have a glide slope.
Yeah.
And since you won't get a glide path with a GPS approach, nor a glide slope with a VOR or a localizer approach, we're going to ask for an ILS today. So David's scanning quickly below to see his analog instruments in order to gauge whether he's too high, too low. He was about 100 feet high, and so he brought the pitch down 1 degree there in order to lose that extra 100 feet. November 8, 2 Delta Hotel, we understand that you've had an air data computer failure, and we can offer the ILS to Stockton. The conditions at Stockton are 1,000 foot overcast with 3 miles visibility.
I'll take that. I'll take the ILS at Stockton if you can give me vectors to get me onto the approach.
November 8, 2 Delta Hotel, roger. Descend and maintain 3,500 and continue flying heading 070. And advise when you have the Stockton ADIS information.
Descend and maintain 3,500 current heading, and I'll get the weather and get set up for the approach to Delta Hotel.
Is there anything else that you might like to ask of air traffic control to help assist you to increase the safety of your flight?
They're going to give me traffic separation anyway.
Okay.
Right?
That would be natural.
I've asked them for vectors. What else would I ask them for?
You might let them know that because the altitude information is going to be challenging for you to scan, that they might want to watch you closely on altitude.
Okay, ask for regular reports on altitude.
Yeah, have them call off any altitude deviations.
3,500 climbing for 4,000.
The ILS 29, right?
That's correct.
Falling to Stockton for practice approaches.
QSEC's a good one to load in for long.
QSEC is what you would use if you had a loss of communications.
Maintain VFR, squawking 574.
Because then you could fly the procedure turn. But you'll be radar vector to final today, so I don't think that'll be necessary.
My tow direct Oakland down to 6, goes 4451.
There you go, Diger looks great.
Yeah, Diger looks good.
Maintain interval of 5,000 for
traffic. I'll look up the chart in a minute.
256338, requesting just three ILSs over to 29 and remain below 5,000.
2-5, 2 miles
left on
RD, descending to the stop. 23-8, looking. Back entire information, Golf, 2055, Zulu observation, winds 320 at 14, gust 22, visibility 10, sky clear. Temperature 21, 0.7, altimeter 3005. Visual approach, runway 29 right is in use. Landing and departing, runway 29 left, 29 right. Advise an initial contact you have. Golf. Back entire information, Golf. 2055 Zulu observation. Winds 320 at
1,000. This is going to maintain.
Approaching 4,500 to go. 700 to go right now.
Altimeter 3005. Visual approach, runway 29 right is in use. Landing and departing, runway 29 left, 29 right. Advise an initial contact you have, Golf.
So So we have Golf at Stockton, 2-Hotel, knockout approach, 2-Hotel, I have Golf at Stockton, descending through 4,000, please confirm my altitude.
November 8, 2-Hotel, we do show you at 4,000, continue descent 3,500 at this time.
Continuing descent 3,500, 2-Hotel.
Visual approach, please.
Source, tune and identify. 109.1.
232 AI. It's important to note that these barrel minimums that you're setting there,
yes,
will not receive a call out.
Okay.
Because the computer has no way to recognize that you've actually reached 340 feet.
Right. But the good news is it will show up here.
It ought to when you get within 2,500 of the ground.
And I busted my altitude.
Okay, but you caught it only a little over 100 feet low. Good. Bringing that nose up. You want to make gradual corrections, so you'd like to see that that circle is about one circle's height above the horizon. Perfect, right there. And any adjustment that you make, you try to make 1, maybe 2 degrees at a time.
Yeah, gas undercarriage mixture and
belt check. Okay. So that's good. I see that you've completed your stick for the inbound course. November 8, 2-Delta Hotel, descend and maintain 2,000, turn left heading 030.
2,000 on the heading, and repeat the heading again.
Left heading 030, 2-Delta Hotel.
030 on the heading, down to 2,000, 2-Delta Hotel.
NorCal approach, Cirrus 82-Delta Hotel request.
Cirrus 82-Delta Hotel, NorCal, say request.
Cirrus 82-Delta Hotel is an SR-22 slant golf. We're 7 miles to the west of Modesto, 3,300 descending. We'd like vectors for the practice. ILS runway 29 right at Stockton. We've got information, golf, if you could vector us on outside of Sims with the published mist.
Delta Hotel, maintain VFR, squawk 5745.
5745, A2 Delta Hotel.
NorCal approach, Bonanza 565.
I'll check, 2900, descending to 2000,
Bonanza 65
heading 030. We're seeing a glide path starting to come in.
5.25, 65 Mike.
And on the flight plan,
November 82 Delta Hotel, turn left heading 020.
020 on the heading, 2 Delta Hotel.
Stockton Altimore 3003.
Make sure you're checking your airspeed.
Yep.
Here's 2 Delta Hotel, radar contact 5 miles west, Modesto Airport. Stockton Altimore 3003, squawk altitude.
3003, 82 Delta Hotel.
Cirrus 2 Delta Hotel, say altitude and squawk altitude.
A2 Delta Hotel, we're simulating an air data computer failure, which may interfere with the proper operation of the air data computer. Is it okay if we continue through this one approach?
Cirrus 2 Delta Hotel, say altitude.
We're at 2,000, A2 Delta Hotel. Let's turn left heading 010.
Oh, that one's activated already. Perfect.
Let's turn left 010 to stay clear of Modesto's airspace.
010 on the heading. We're at 2,000 feet. Our airspeed is
2 Delta Hotel, maintain VFR. Fly heading 020, vector ILS final approach course.
020 to intercept A2 Delta Hotel.
There's 2 Delta Hotel, upon completion of this approach, execute the published missed approach, maintain VFR at or above 3,000, return this frequency.
Published missed above 3,000, A2 Delta Hotel.
Yep. Look at that right now.
for your flight path indicator to be a little bit above to correct that small
discrepancy. Oh, yeah, I was looking at these discrepancies.
Yeah,
that's
there
the wrong thing.
And that's a great way to fix it. If you just pop in those flaps, that'll balloon you right up. And
yeah, exactly.
You can ease that flight path indicator back down to the line. Good.
Yeah, Oops. Now, 256338 will be requesting three ILSs into Stockton.
2338, upon completion of all approaches, fly heading 050, maintain VFR 2000, return to frequency.
Okay,
the thing that I have briefed is the missed approach.
Climbing to 2000.
Of your flight path indicator.
Oh, yeah.
Goodness. It's not easy with thermals, is it?
No, it's not.
November 8, 2 Delta.
You can expect a vector across the final. There's a jet inbound perspective.
Understood, 8 2 Delta Hotel. Okay, November 8 2 Delta Hotel, we show you about 200 feet high.
2 Delta Hotel, confirm that.
I have 2 Delta Hotel, say again, altitude.
8 2 Delta Hotel is 2,200.
2 Delta Hotel, maintain VFR 2,000.
VFR 2,000, 8 2 Delta Hotel.
So he's got us on radar, and that's what's giving him the altitude?
He doesn't have any altitude other than what we're calling. So we want to get that flight path indicator just below the horizon.
Yeah. With all these thermals, it's not easy.
SoCal, yep. November 956, Golf request.
November 9568, Golf, NorCal, say request.
And keep it below.
9568, Golf, 6972, Snatch Golf.
Okay, so you've finished your stick. You can see that we're
iOS 25 right.
That was a pretty good little thermal on one wing.
Yeah, it certainly was.
Okay, and you've not activated the leg that we're going to be vectored to.
I have not activated it.
No.
That's interesting because I thought that I was going across this leg and Diger was activated to Sims.
Okay, did you confirm that that's what's active on your PFD? Because if you look up here, it says that you're going from Stockton to Diger.
That's interesting.
Yeah, it is interesting, isn't it?
November 9 or 5.
Now, how are we going to fix that?
Maintain VFR, squawk 5746.
VFR 9746, 956 takeoff.
Okay. Well, that would work. Good.
Yeah.
All right, so we're active outside of Sims. And
we're at 2,000.
Lead up 526, 3,000.
And he did say we're getting vectors across final. This is good situational awareness. Shows exactly what we're up to, that we're not heading towards any substantial terrain. Not for another...
And it's possible, given where we are, that he might vector us in between Sims and Cusacks. But, oh, you did ask for outside Sims, didn't you?
I did, yep. So it looks like we've got over 10 miles that we could continue on this heading, but he'll probably bring us out around momentarily.
The hotel, turn right, heading 110.
Right turn 110, 82 Delta Hotel.
Approach Cougar 86, check the impact.
Yeah, so he's taking us to the right in order to give us plenty of room to make that.
Let's increase the scale on that so it gives you a little
Cougar
more information.
Approach Stockton Altimeter 3003, verify information golf for Stockton and say request.
Affirm 3003, we have information golf request.
I'm sorry, what is it you just did? On the range?
I just changed the range
on the inside.
To a more useful scale, it was down to 2 miles.
Your own navigation.
Cougar 86, maintain VFR, proceed as requested. You can expect
other things to note that you've lost with the air data computer failure is the outside air temperature information. You've also lost your true airspeed info and your wind data. It's got no way of computing wind information when you've lost ADC. We've also lost the underspeed protection and overspeed protection because if it can't see the airspeed, it can't tell you whether you're too fast or too slow.
Right.
So if you ever were to stall in this condition, it would give you a full autopilot stall with the potential for a spin.
Delta, turn right, heading 200.
Right turn, heading 200, 82 Delta Hotel. You're doing very nicely on your altitude now. Holding 2,000.
And my airspeed, and my engine management too.
Yep, everything looks good. Airspeed's a little slow, but that's because of the thermals bouncing you around.
And we've climbed another 100 feet, so I'm correcting for that. Yeah, I'm more going on my power setting than I am on anything else, because if I maintain 45%.
You also notice that your turns are made at half standard rate?
Yes.
So that might be something that's worth advising air traffic control, that all your turns will be at half standard rate. It'll enable them to plan better when vectoring you to final.
Yep.
It really does make a difference when you're turning half as fast.
My nose
36 over, hold over exit at above 3,500.
236, hold over half-ex at above 3,500.
338, turn left heading 010.
Left heading 010, Mighty 338.
The 68 Golf Raider contact, 3 miles south, Livermore report. Fighting 010, Vector's ILS approach. Vector will take you over the localizer for right now.
Fighting 010, localizer 25 right of them.
Turn 2 Delta Hotel, turn right heading 270.
Turn right heading 270, 2 Delta Hotel.
2 Delta Hotel, if you want further approaches after this approach, I need to turn everything back on.
Will code, 2 Delta Hotel, and this is the only one.
2 Delta Hotel, intercept the localizer.
Intercept localizer, 82 Delta Hotel.
68 Golf, this Vector will take you over the localizer for the right downwind.
Over localizer for downwind, 952 takeoff.
Okay, good. So when given the directive to intercept the localizer, David smartly hit the nav button.
Legion 526, airport in sight.
526, third visual approach from Wheat, 29 right.
Clear for the visual, 29 right, Allegiant 526.
Although even with the approach button, you wouldn't have the glide slope arm to capture. There's no glide slope function to capture with.
This approach, maintain VFR at above 3,500.
VFR at above 3,500, A2 Delta Hotel.
338, how does approach terminate?
I'll be asking for two more ILSs after this one, sir.
338, after this approach, flooding 050, maintain VFR, return this frequency.
After the approach, turn heading 050, climb to 2,000.
Good, you had a little power adjustment there, and that caused a little sink.
Yeah.
Sir.
2 Delta Hotel, 5 miles from Sims, maintain VFR, cut ILS, runway 290 right approach.
VFR cleared ILS, 29 right, 2 Delta Hotel.
2 Delta Hotel, caution weight turbines, you're 6 miles behind an MD-80.
Thank you, A2 Delta Hotel.
For 68 Golf, verify you have information, Bravo, Livermore.
I have information, Bravo for Livermore, 956 your call.
Legion 526, Phoenix Stockton Tower.
Legion 526, see ya.
338, descend to maintain 3,000.
Down to 3,000, 2238.
Now on the mist, you're going to notice one other problem. It's not going to recognize when you've reached this 500 foot point.
Okay.
And so it's not going to turn you to the heading of 010. Okay. You would have to force it into heading mode and then activate the leg to orang in order to successfully complete the missed approach procedure.
Okay.
So you will have a little challenge there as well.
28 sled, uniform approximately 1-3 miles from the Manticup UR on 050 radio at 2500. Request radar vector for practical ILS at Stockton with information golf will be pushed up.
So it looks like this barrow information is not popping up because it doesn't know that you're within 2,500 feet of the ground. That's when it's supposed to start displaying it.
Okay.
I can leave it here if you want.
I'm approaching the catch on the glide slope, so I'm reducing my power to 25% so I don't speed down.
Very good. Yeah, you want to stick with your normal ILS profile. We don't know what the wind is, but we can assume that we've got a good amount of headwind, given that the METAR was calling for 14 gusting to 21, I believe it was.
Gas, make sure my boost pump is on, undercarriage.
All right, 2 Delta Hotel, wind check.
Stockton wind 310 at 10, gusts 20.
Thank you very much, 82 Delta Hotel. So right down the runway, 10 gusting to 20. Maybe a little bit from the right-hand side.
Yeah, the problem with these thermals is you tend to overcorrect on the pitch.
Yep. That's why it's better to do just 1 degree at a time. So you can see that flight path indicator is way too high. You click it one down.
Yeah.
You see where it ends up.
Good afternoon, Stockton Tower, 256338.
I clicked it one down and see where it goes.
256338.
That's because of the thermal.
Yeah, exactly.
Cirrus ahead 6 miles.
So now you have to increase your power to catch the glide slope again.
Mooney 48, Whiskey contact, NorCal departure. Have a good flight.
Go on and rock out, Mike. 4 with you. Thank you.
You're at 80 knots.
Yeah.
What this will not tell you is that you're approaching a stall.
A stall speed, yep. No, yeah. I was keeping an eye on that.
Anytime you see that attitude getting up too high in order to maintain the glide path or glide slope, then
yep.
You want to make sure that you're giving it as much power as you need to.
Yep.
Okay, good.
Now we've lost the glide slope again because the thermals just bumped it right above it.
Do you want to try hand flying the rest of it?
Yeah, it'd be easier, I think.
It may be easier, given the strength of these thermals and the slow response of the autopilot.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're getting right back down on that glide slope. Where should that flight path indicator be aimed?
Right on the runway.
Right to the runway. So let's get it over
exactly.
there.
Exactly, yep. Okay.
You can use a little rudder to assist. Okay, that looks a lot better.
Yeah, this is a lot easier than autopilot.
Yeah, so the autopilot can help get you in a good position, and then it may become necessary when there's a lot of bumps to disconnect and hand fly the remainder. Now, we're approaching 700 feet, so if you truly had marginal conditions, you'd be out of the clouds by now and completing the rest of your approach visually.
Yeah.
Oh, we'll go ahead and continue down to minimums for practice.
Yes, it's interesting to get into your head that sometimes in these with an ADC failure, your autopilot can actually be your worst enemy because it gets you into a stall without realizing it.
Yeah, good point.
Okay, we are at minimums. We're below minimums.
Okay, good. Go miss.
Climb to 500.
And you weren't below minimums. Minimums were 232.
Yeah.
You're just below your personal limitations. Okay, good. Go and publish missed.
So we're going to a heading of 010 now that we climbed to 5,000 feet.
Hey, 2 Delta Hotel's on the go.
Cirrus 2 Delta Hotel, contact NorCal departure.
Over to NorCal, 2 Delta Hotel.
So we're at 1,000.
Okay.
And we can put our heading and autopilot back on and keep it in pitch mode until we get to 2,000, and then we want to make sure we activate this leg here.
Yes. Excellent. And then autopilot goes to
nav mode.
All right.
Yep.
Have you gone through all your C's? Let's call them out loud.
Communicate.
Cram.
Cram, clang, clean.
There you go. Comply with the mist, and that means also spinning in the altitude.
Yeah.
Reminder to 3,500, which is what they issued us. And we'll go over to NorCal. All right, very good. NorCal departure, Cirrus 82 Delta Hotel is 2,300 climbing 3,500 for Orang.
82 Delta Hotel, NorCal approach, radar contact, maintain VFR at above 3,500.
VFR at or above 3,500, we will climb 4.5 direct Palo Alto, 82 Delta Hotel.
82 Delta, are you going to Orang or going to Palo Alto?
We'll discontinue the missed approach procedure and we can proceed at this time direct to Palo Alto.
82 Delta Hotel, Retro, and you can turn your remote feedback on.
Okay, do you see it at this time, 82 Delta Hotel?
82 Delta Hotel, I'm showing 2,900 now.
That's affirmative.